the space that we had is what I tried to maximize. I tried to bring in as much light as possible and to make the inside as light and bright as possible as well. I'm not quite sure that there's any design we can call African per se. However, I think that the design should be influenced by a lot of features. Things like the climate should affect, sort of like affect the kind of design that you end up with.
I've looked at your ceiling, your walls. I was coming up the stairs. I was looking at the different materials that you've used. Did you have like a full picture of what you wanted in your house? Or did you just go along and, you know, you just came to this beautiful design that we see here?
Let me say that there are quite a number of things that I knew that I wanted and some things that I knew that I didn't want. Details like the flooring, and I think that the things that make a house really are your floor, your ceiling and your walls. And if you keep those things as simple as possible, you find out that the whole design ties to, because the other things you can move around and change. So I probably paid a lot more attention to my finishes.
A lot of architects, a lot of homeowners, developers don't bring the interior designer from the start of the project. You have limitations, like the limitations are in this blocks. When it was built. Going forward, what would you advise them?
I guess being an architect, I was able to look at the design off plan, and that helped me decide which of the units I would sort of would choose.
Young, talented designers are coming up, and we have a lot of the older designers that the younger ones respect because they've been there older, but not necessarily want to emulate. If you look around and you see the designs that we have today in Lagos, you can see that there's something about to come out, but it's coming out more from the younger generation.
I feel that design is influenced by a lot of travels and what you pick up from different places. And I think that the younger generation are probably better traveled than the older ones. There's no way anyone can design without having seen certain things. And I think that majority of the Nigerian architects or designers probably haven't traveled wide enough. And there's no way you can, like I said, design without having seen and experienced. So it's also experiences. You know, you go maybe to the Caribbean, or you go to South Africa, or you go on a boat. There are lots of things that you will see as you maybe sail along or whatever. And I think that all these things influence the way you would perceive and design.